This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you today by Scope. For a positive reaction, unleash the power of Scope. And by Cascade. Powder and liquid Cascade for virtually spotless dishes. We'll continue with part two of As the World Turns in just a moment. As the World Turns.
Caleb? Caleb Snyder, come in from those fields before you kill yourself.
I'm right here. I'm here.
Look at you. You're all drenched. I want to tell you something, young man. You can't turn off your mind by killing yourself.
Yeah, I just discovered that.
Boy.
Oh, no, Mama, you're gonna get all dirty.
It's been that way most of my life. Hasn't killed me yet.
Yeah, don't you go dying either.
Dying? All right, I'll make you a deal. I'll stay alive for the rest of your life, and I'll take care of you in your old age, okay?
It's a good thing. It's a cinch nobody else will.
Oh, Caleb. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry about what's happened between you and Angel.
Oh, what? You mean that she dumped me? Yeah. So am I. More than I thought I'd be.
She was very upset when she left here. You know that?
Yeah. She was, but not about me. Mama, if you ever know somebody so well that you feel as though you can just read their minds?
Yeah, you. And your father. Your father and I hardly had to say a word. We knew it was on each other's minds.
Yeah. Well, I had that with Angel before. And today when she said she'd come back to return those gifts to me, I knew she was lying.
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, she could have just had them sent back. It would have been easier. She wanted to be with Holden in the car, just the two of them.
I don't understand. What?
Mama, Angel's falling in love with Holden. I know it.
But doesn't she know how much she loves Lily?
Yes, she knows. But beyond that sweet little face is the hardest head east or west of the Mississippi.
Oh, okay.
If she wants him, Mama, she's going to get him.
How can you be sure of this?
Well, I wasn't until today, but I asked her if she loved Holden, and she just ran. So I had my answer. I don't think we should tell Lily or Holden.
I won't. But I'm afraid that Angel's going to get hurt. I'd really hate to see that.
So would I, Mama.
I'm going to relax until we know what Lilith is here for.
I know damn well why she's here. She's spoken to you.
Huh? She's totally ignored me. At one point, she looked at me. Though she'd never seen me before, she did the same to Tobias. He thinks that she's blocked that portion of her life out of her memory, which might be good.
Don't take anything for granted. She's as changeable as she is lethal. I'm afraid to go anywhere near Shannon. I fear that Lilith will count her a rival. Did you see her when Emily was talking to me?
I saw. It made my blood run cold. Speaking of Shannon.
And if you would like to, I would just adore having you model at my restaurant.
I might be. I'm not sure how long I'll be here.
Oh, where are you staying?
I'm not sure about that either.
Just what we need around here, a woman of mystery.
Are you in the fashion business?
Careful, this is the competition.
And your friends? I hate any competition. I hate it.
Hi, you're great today, by the way.
Thank you. Are you in the business?
No, I just love clothes.
I saw you whispering earlier to the owner of this castle. I presume you're friends.
Well, Duncan and I have known each other a long time, but no, I wouldn't call him a friend.
What would you call him?
Handsome. Charming. That's about the weirdest conversation I've ever had.
I guess when you're that stylish, it's okay to be weird.
Yeah.
Oh, lovely.
Jay, Shannon, can you see anything here today you'd like to buy?
Yeah, the whole line. Wrap it up. Listen, Jess, you're close with Duncan these days. Why is he acting so strange?
I didn't realize he was.
Well, yes, during the fashion show, he turned pale like he'd seen a ghost or something, and every time I try to go near him, he runs away.
Well, maybe I should talk to him. I'll be back.
Thanks.
Wait a minute. You know, we came here to spend a little time with you, Nella, and I, and we want to enjoy ourselves.
Yeah, well, I want to enjoy myself, too, but I need to talk to my client right now. I'll be back.
Seems to me, Big Brother, you have a choice between that jealousy of yours and Jessica. And from what I hear, jealousy doesn't keep you warm at night.
Shannon tells me that you look like you've seen a ghost. Could its name be Lilith?
She's the model that Lisa introduced as Isabella. She's right over there. I wish you were a ghost.
She came in with the models. We never anticipated that.
I should have known that. She always wanted to be a model. She was always more self-assured in front of people than anyone I ever knew.
She enjoys the spotlight. I think it calms her.
We can't take her out of it. Not until everyone leaves. The consequences would be rather unpleasant.
Listen, I need to speak with you. Can you? I know this is an imposition. Can you stay after everyone has left? I may need a lawyer more tonight than I've ever needed one before.
Take yourself out of this room.
I'll stay, but I don't know how I'm going to explain it to Lori.
Who is that interesting African woman over there?
What? That's Jessica Griffin. She's a very successful lawyer here in Oakdale. And if I were you, I wouldn't refer to her as that African woman.
Why not? I'm from Africa originally, too. I'm very proud of it. Animals and humans can coexist there. Like an Eden. Outside the dark continent, if you mix the two, it's unnatural, don't you think?
Find out what's wrong with Duncan.
Yes, it's the crowd, Jen, and he's just not used to having so many people in the castle.
Well, it's all the more reason for him to be civil to those of us who does know that.
Excuse me. Hello. Remember me? I mean, I know that you found a new bed warmer in place, but is there any reason for us to be strangers?
Aye, it's a bloody good reason. You told me that you were never going to set foot in this castle after I told you about Teresa. Now, I wish you'd keep your word for once. I don't want you anywhere near around me. Do you understand?
Oh, this is just crazy.
That's supposed to be a newsflash?
It's past midnight in Akros, and Margot still isn't in her room.
What, did you try Craig?
Yes, I tried the hotel. There's lots of messages for him. I'm worried about both of them now.
Well, maybe Margot might have gone into labor.
Okay.
But no, don't get bent out of shape. Let's just go home and wait for Craig's call there, okay?
Yeah, let's do it.
Slow down. Ladies, Emily, how was the rest of the reception?
Oh, it was fun. Duncan was a little strained. I don't know why. Anyway, there was this model there. She was a real weirdo.
Yeah, right. Oh, well, I want to hear about this model sometime, okay?
Okay, you got it, Casey. Oh.
Did you ever notice that Casey's very sexy?
I noticed he's very married.
Oh, you mean kind of like John Dixon?
Hey, John Dixon is my friend, so get off my case.
Goodbye. Oh, I'll use a different one. But Meg,
what?
Tony has a dinner meeting tonight. I don't know if he told you or not.
Yes, he told me. You don't have to fill me in on my husband's agenda anymore. He can do that himself.
Is there something wrong?
Think about it, Emily. I bet you can figure it out.
And that's why the job in Madison seems like such a good opportunity for me.
Will it really give you more time with Danny?
Well, I think so. They've guaranteed that I could work at home in the afternoons, which is perfect while she's in school in the morning, and who knows, if I can get the office back on its feet, then maybe they'll have something better for me here if I decide to come back.
Yeah, come back as soon as you can. It's not going to feel the same without you.
Come on. You forget all about me. You'll wonder, now, who was that woman who lived here? That tall woman, the one with all the problems.
Betsy who? Huh?
Right.
I'll always love you.
I hope we can always be friends. I mean that.
You know the five words I dreaded most as a kid? Can't we just be friends? Oh, God.
one good thing about that statement is that at least we're no longer teenagers, right?
Thank goodness, yeah.
Hello. Yeah, Emily, I wanted to talk to you. No, whenever it's good for you, just listen. You said some very hurtful things about someone I love very much and always will. This is it. I think I live here.
Kiria!
Hi.
I don't know whether you remember me or not. I'm Margot Hughes.
Hi. Yes, you're the, your brother.
Craig. Yes. You and your mother-in-law, you nursed him back to health after his plane crash, and...
Yes.
I'm a sister.
I know. Go slower, please.
Okay, I'm sorry. Craig, my brother, is here. Well, in Akros.
Ah.
And he would like to see you.
Ah, wonderful. Irte o adofosis, kirias, Katerina Sumilisi. When?
Probably very soon. I know this is an imposition to ask you this. I'd appreciate it. Is it possible that I could...
Go slower, please.
I'm sorry. May I stay the night with you until my brother comes? I know it's late.
Μπορεί να μείνει εδώ τη νύχτα.
Ναι. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I appreciate this very much. Thank you very much. Nikos, thank you. Thank you very much for taking me out here.
Δεν κάνει τίποτα. It's nothing. Bye-bye.
Καλή νύχτα.
I'm sort of a good luck charm. They all kind of rub me.
Come in. I get you some milk, huh?
Yes, thank you.
Excuse me, this is gonna work. Do you speak English by any chance?
A bit. I understand better.
You do? Look, I've been wandering around the waterfront for several hours now. I'm trying to find... Have you seen this woman here tonight? You have? Did she by any chance take a boat to this island? It's called Livia. This one right here. She did. Can you take me there? Please, no, look, I'll pay you any amount of money you want. This is very important to me. I'm her husband.
You are this husband?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sure.
Thank you for helping me close up the barn. You know, you have really done your share of work today. You're turning out to be quite a farmer.
Yeah, I know you mean that as a compliment, Mama. And I do love helping you, but you know that's never what I really wanted.
Well, we're going to have dinner alone tonight. And maybe you can tell me a little bit about what you really do want. But what I told you when you were a little boy is still true.
Red sky at night, sailor's delight.
No.
A gathering stone creates moss.
Hey, no, now you listen to me. I told you that you can be whatever you want to be. And I still mean that. It's not too late. Not too late for someone as special as you. That's true.
Thanks, Mom.
Wait a minute. Before we go inside, I want to thank you for being so understanding about my messing up your birthday
party. Hey, you're here now.
It was real nice of Lisa to give you the night off, huh?
Well, she knew you were going to Chicago tomorrow, and she knew I wanted to spend the whole evening with you.
You know something? When Craig gets back, I'm going to ask him if we can switch duties. Have him take over the Lang account, and I'll run the offices here.
But I thought the Lang account was a challenge to you.
It is, but I think that we need to spend as much time as we can together.
Mm-hmm, I like the sound of that. Let's start tonight.
Barbara gave me strict instructions that we were to leave this room and the room upstairs where the models are changing in perfect condition.
Well, that was very thoughtful of her. Everything looks fairly close to normal.
Duncan McKechnie, I had no ideas. What a good sport you are. We really had a wonderful time. It was so kind of you to let us use this place, and it was so romantic.
I found it a bit nerve-wracking. Oh. Are all the models still upstairs?
Yes, all of them, yes.
I'll get them out of your hair as soon as they're finished changing, Duncan.
Look, I don't believe you, Jessica. You know Mom and Papa coming by the apartment after they go to the movies. What am I supposed to say to them, huh?
We can always tell them that she's working late, that she'll come back soon, and then we keep them happy until she gets there. It's really not that big a deal.
No, Roy, believe me, I know that this must irritate you, but I wouldn't be staying if it weren't important. Now, just please try to understand.
Oh, yeah, I understand. I understand. I got nothing to say about this. I'll see you later, okay? Come on, now, let's get out of here.
We're leaving now.
Okay, great. Thanks again for everything. I don't know how we're ever going to repay you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I've got the stuff.
No, not now. You could send her right over the edge. She's in control now, but she's capable of hurting all those other women.
That's exactly why I can't let her go.
We'll find her. I really don't think she remembers anything. But if you open the floodgates, she might be dangerous. Now let her be. For now.
No, listen, just to be safe, I think we should go upstairs and check the room where Lilith was changing with the other models. Hmm?
Of course.
Duncan, I know you've had a terrible day. Why don't you have a drink and get something to eat and try to relax?
You take your hands off him.
Thank you very much, both of you. I appreciate you taking me in like this. I just hope that Craig gets my note soon and gets a boatman to bring him over.
Oh, was the boat trip was bad for you?
Well, it was, I mean, the motion of the sea, it just, my condition is not very good.
Mm.
You want to see the Axel?
She says two men are just outside the house.
Oh, good. That must be Craig.
Hello, Margot. It's nice to see you.
Stay tuned for Guiding Light, next on most of these CBS stations. Bags and Belts by Oscar De La Renta. Join us tomorrow for As the World Turns.